why Summit is important is it's so obvious that I have a hard time thinking I have to explain that to someone. Most of our system is set up so that you go to high school and then from high school you go to college. And if that doesn't work for you, you're left behind.
We, society, is fed this myth that for you to move into an IT occupation, you need to have a bachelor's or a master's. I start reading the research. We found that 53% of STEM jobs do not require a bachelor's degree or above. That's a lot of jobs. And that is where the growth is.
I don't look at people being left behind as they failed. No, the system kind of failed you.
Employer partnerships is why students come to Summit.
We have all these open jobs because we're growing extremely rapidly. We're bringing on larger clients quicker than we can kind of keep up with. What we've run into is a lack of dedicated, passionate, and hardworking individuals.
Many of our students have faced significant barriers or experienced challenges.
School was rough for me because, you know, we did not have access to computers and stuff.
They're persistent. Our students have grit.
I always want to learn more every time I see stuff, so I became the guy in the family who used to like fix stuff that is broken, phones, you know, TV.
And they're serious about making a good income, getting a good career.
I just wanted to get my GED and go to college afterwards.
When you deliver a platform with committed instructors, with quality education, and you attach it to a career, you can get people through the door.
What we do is literally from that first day, Atomic is involved in the program. So every week we're bringing in a guest speaker. They're learning about growth positions in the company. They're learning about what they can do long term. He was one of our students who, again, a little quieter in the back of class, but did so well. And the questions he asked were very inquisitive and showed that while he's quiet, there's a lot of gears in his head turning and he's understanding and thinking more in depth about how do these systems work.
So they're acclimating to the culture, they're understanding the needs of the employer. What we've created is a seamless path into employment.
Look where we are right now, you know, we have a great life, a career, you know, that's great, you know, what more we need, you know.
And the sky is the limit. That's the other cool thing. Take where they are and move into 100K plus positions. That's kind of mind-blowing when you think about that. We need to be very proactive about developing the future workforce. And that starts at a young age.
A lot of times our students are behind when it comes to STEM. You wouldn't find much technology in our school in comparison to other schools serving a more affluent population.
We already have a digital gap or a digital divide. This is just going to increase over time. There's an urgency for us to address this.
I think that there's a narrative about students that come through poor circumstances that they don't have the mental capacity to do STEM. They think about that themselves. And so by exposing them early, they can create a new narrative.
And you set them up for what the jobs will look like in the future.
What I hope is that more students become inspired about school and they can make that connection to the real world and real world opportunities.
We are in a geography with a tremendous amount of talent, and to look at North Minneapolis as the STEM hub for the Twin Cities is pretty awesome.